All right, so let's talk about the Free report, of course, because this has gotten a lot of coverage. It was a scathing report. And it concluded, quote, four of the most powerful people at Pennsylvania State University, including Spanier and Joe Paterno, failed to protect against a child sexual predator harming children for the past decade. Let's listen to what Graham Spanier said to you about the report.
The Free report is wrong. It's unfair. It's deeply flawed. It is as many errors and omissions. I know they had a lot of very good people on that team working on this. They interviewed, they say, over 430 people. Many of those folks have spoken to me about their interviews. Many of them described those interviews to me as a witch hunt.
A witch hunt. That sounds defensive.
Yeah, he's pretty defensive, and he's very angry about it. And frankly, I don't buy that it was a witch hunt. But whether, in fact, Spanier is culpable here is much more of an open question than I thought.
You asked him about an email, though, in which they were talking about trying to be more humane towards Jerry Sandusky, one of the damning emails. And let's listen to that and then get your takeaway from what he said. Here's Mr. Spanier.
I think what many people wanted to read into it was humane for us not to turn him in for being a known child predator. But I never, ever heard anything about child abuse or sexual abuse, or were my antenna raised up enough to even suspect that?
This is, again, where I'm confused. Horseplay between a naked man and a naked teenager in a shower. How does that not...
So fascinating. Yeah. Graham Spanier, before he became a college administrator, was a sociologist with a specialty in child abuse. I mean, this is something he knows about tremendously, and he says... He's a big intervener as an administrator. He says his antenna was not raised. He said he asked Schultz and Curley, what was this orbit? Are you sure it was nothing more than horseplay? Again, he says that's all he was told. It's not clear what horseplay was to him, but they did not do what they could have done in 2001.
Very quickly, tenured professor at Penn State. He still is one, despite all of this. Is he being paid?
He sure is. Yes, he is. He's no longer living in the president's house, but he is still a tenured professor. His wife is a tenured professor, and they intend, as far as I can tell, to stay there at least for the foreseeable future.
All right, Jeff.